What is your break in the industry story? What would you say is that moment that it really hit you like, wow? It's that moment where you feel accomplished. You really feel like this is the moment. What goes through your head? What inspires you to create? People can assume they know. What has been the highest point for you? It's basically, we want to tell people's break in the industry story.
You already know what it is. It's your boy OSH T. We've been rocking with breaking the industry. Make sure you follow me at OSH T SAD at everything.
The moment where I felt like I had my break in the industry wasn't until this season right here.
Really?
Yeah, this is when the moment that I knew that like I really made it. Because my first 5 years on television, it was just like, all right, I'm there. But I didn't capitalize on all of the opportunities that was there for me. It has a little bit to do with everything. Like, I was younger. Like, I wasn't using my money properly. I wasn't using my time properly, probably because I was trying to, you know, focus on other stuff. But now I have unlimited free time to actually get my work done.
So what moment on this season was it where it was like, no, this is it for me?
Once I got my first check, and then like, I realized that I didn't have to live like check to check anymore, because like I have amazing saving strategies now, so I just save money, and
awesome.
Now I'm just like, all right, I'm good for the rest of my life now. As long as I can keep on making money, then I'm always going to have money. Because for 5 years of television, I was just having fun.
I was just
doing what I wanted to do. But now that I'm married and, you know, I have children, like, I'm an adult now. Like, I'm officially 35, and I realized that my whole life is transitioning. I was into art my whole life. Luckily, the neighborhood that I grew up in, everyone was artists. Everybody was graffiti writers. And like, after that, they transitioned from being graffiti writers into tattoo artists. At that time, I was still doing graffiti, and like, I was getting locked up for doing graffiti and stuff like that. One of the older G's told me, yo, like, make money doing this shit. I grew up in the Bronx.
Wow.
Yeah, the Kingsbridge area.
So that's like the Mecca of hip hop.
Oh yeah, I know. Like, I was into all of that. And it's so crazy to me, because people who are not from up north don't really know the whole subculture between like graffiti, breakdance,
yeah,
and all
that's
that
all
shit.
Like,
I did all of it, yeah.
Oh really?
Yeah, all the way.
Cool.
I didn't really take my art serious until probably like I was 18 or so. Like, when I first bought my tattoo equipment. Other than that, it was just graffiti, and like, graffiti was fun, even though, you know, we would still write like in people's books and stuff, but it wasn't the same thing as actually doing art. You know, just being around tattoo stuff, like, I just start drawing stuff. Like, honestly, I don't know what I'm gonna do on a paper until like I just put my pen to it, and then it just goes. It's kind of easy to separate reality from reality TV, because the cameras go down sometimes, and, you know, people stop screaming, and then people start, you know, just breathing and realizing that, you know what, it doesn't have to always be this. Like, some of the most nastiest and hurtful things come on social media.
Yeah.
But the real way to do it is, I personally, I don't be on my social media sometimes. Sometimes I'm like, yo, handle this. Mm-hmm. And then all she does is she'll just start blocking people. As soon as they say something negative, she's like, I don't even, like, half the time when I'm communicating to people online, it's not me. It'd be her. I'm just like, take the gram. It does fuck with you sometimes.
Yeah.
And like, one, there was not too long ago, probably like 1 month ago, me and my wife, we were actually having that conversation. Well, maybe we are this person. Then we start laying down in the bed, yeah, and we're just like, no. Look at everything that we built. Like, people aren't gonna actually know us. Like, if you don't spend time with us, and that's fine. But like, you can have your perception, as long as it doesn't affect, you know, my actual house, then it's cool. But the second that it does start affecting your household, then, you know, obviously you have to speak on it.
Now, do you feel like it affects your life a little bit more? Because I feel like social media is so tough on her because of the way VH1 portrayed her.
Because no one knew anything about her. Yeah.
Right, and then the first perception is what they put out there. So people believe that, and they take that, and they're like, that's her. And it's like, okay, that's not her. But, you know, they attack her the most.
Yeah, I mean, she's definitely a Black Ink villain, and, you know, there's nothing I can say about that. Like, I know her, but I'm the only person who really needs to know who my wife is.
True.
Because nobody else matters. Like, what matters is that what happens between me and my wife. And like, that's the most important thing. People can have their opinions, just don't disrespect.
Right. You had like some drama between everybody because they were talking about.
Oh yeah.
You know, did that really interfere with your relationships with them?
Honestly, it did. It did interfere with my relationships with some people. But you know what? Some people did apologize.
Okay.
And like, I can take that. I understand it. Like, sincerely apologize. Like, Walter went out his way and like made a huge apology on Instagram. And I was just like, you see, nobody knew what that was about except me and him.
Yeah.
It's hard for people. It's a hard coat for people to swallow knowing that, like, I'm not fucking shit up anymore, that I'm on the right page. You know what? Like, yes, I am married. I have a house now. And, you know, I'm doing good. Like, we have multiple businesses that we're starting. So, you know, like, it's a huge change. People don't know how to accept it.
Yeah, that's true. I feel like it's like...
And it's, you know what makes it real hard for people is that, like, trajectory that I've done, like, most people haven't done that yet either. Like, a lot of people are still in the same spot that they were 3 years ago, and like, I've elevated, and you know what, some people might just be angry that, you know what, I'm doing better for myself.
Right.
It makes you look at yourself sometimes.
Right, because people get scared of change.
Yeah.
And it's like, when you change up on them, it's like, oh, you acted different. It's like, no. I'm just better in myself.
Yeah, you know, I'm acting different because you're right. I'm acting different, but you know what? There's nothing wrong with that. Like,
exactly.
I accept it. Like, I'm moving different because I want different results.
Absolutely.
Definition of insanity is keep doing the same thing over and over and expecting different results. Boom.
Just MTV come knocking on black and like, yo, this shop needs a show.
The shop is popping. I mean,
really?
Like, a lot of people used to, like no one will ever understand what Black Ink was to the community.
Mm-hmm.
Like, literally, everybody would come to Black Ink, celebrities, like actors, TVs, yeah, like TV personalities, just like everybody used to like chill at Black Ink. It used to be like a hub. Like, everyone would link up, chill, we'd have like a party or something like that, or just like after hours events, do dope tattoos, and then one day